Morning, everyone.
Good morning.
And welcome to our second Sunday Mass here in the Gym Church. A few announcements, because many of you have not been here before, so some of you will hear what's been repeated, but you know that there are several changes in our routine. We ask you please to remain seated once you're in your place until you're invited out at the end as we go to communion, and it will be from the back row forward. So again, the last shall be first. After the Holy Holy, we invite you to remain standing instead of kneeling. This is the universal posture for everyone to take when there are no kneelers. Of course, if you cannot stand, please sit. After the priest holds up the body and blood of Christ, please make a bow as he genuflects. At the end of Mass, Father and the Eucharistic minister will go to distribute Holy Communion right inside just by the door. Please wait until an usher leads you. You must receive in the hand and not on the tongue for your safety, that of the minister and those who receive after you. Please take the host, the body of Christ, in your hand and move farther down to consume it with reverence. Thank you very much for your understanding of all this. So, Easter greetings on the solemnity of the Ascension. Today, we recall Christ's ascension to his Father in heaven. Before he left, he promised his disciples that he would be with them always. Indeed, the Lord is with us when we gather in his name, as we listen to the word of God, as the bread and wine are consecrated. Let us celebrate the assurance that Christ is with us always, now until the end of time. And I greet also those who are watching this as we live stream. So we remain in solidarity with one another, whether we are here or praying from our homes. The celebrant today is Father Bob Higgins. The special intentions are in loving memory of Frida Reeder, Marlo Sickerman, Javier Alcorta, Claire Mungra, and for all the parish.
Bind up the wounds inflicted by our sins.
Please respond, Lord, hear us to each petition. Give us the grace of true repentance.
Lord, hear us.
Pardon your servants and release them from the debt of sin.
Lord, hear us.
Forgive your children who confess their sins and restore them to full communion with your church.
Lord, hear us.
Renew the glory of baptism in those who have lost it by sin.
Lord, hear us.
Welcome them to your altar and renew their spirit with the hope of eternal glory.
Lord, hear us.
Keep them faithful to your sacraments and loyal in your service.
Lord, hear us.
Renew your love in their hearts and make them bear witness to it in their daily lives.
Lord, hear us.
Keep them always obedient to your commandments and protect within them your gift of eternal life.
Lord, hear us.
Let us now pray to God as our Father in the words Christ gave us and ask him for his forgiveness and protection from all evil. Our Father,
those of you who wish to receive sacramental absolution, please bow your heads and acknowledge that you are sinners.
My brothers and sisters, confess your sins and pray for each other, that you may be healed. Oh my God, I am heartily sorry for having offended David, and I detest all my sins because of thy just punishments, but most of all because I offend thee, my God, who art all good and deserving of all my love. I firmly resolve, with the help of thy grace, to sin no more and to avoid the near occasions of sin. God the Father does not wish the sinner to die, but to turn back to him and live. He loved us first and sent his Son into the world to be its Savior. May he show you his merciful love and give you peace. Amen. Our Lord Jesus Christ was given up to death for our sins and rose again for our justification. He sent the Holy Spirit on his apostles and gave them power to forgive sins. Through the ministry entrusted to me, may he deliver you from evil and fill you with his Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Spirit, the Comforter, was given to us for the forgiveness of sins. In him we approach the Father. May he cleanse your hearts and clothe you in his glory, so that you may proclaim the mighty acts of God who has called you out of darkness into the splendor of light. Amen. And I absolve you from your sins in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Well, good morning. And happy Feast of the Ascension, and happy Memorial Day. Welcome back. I missed you. This is a historic first for St. John Neumann Catholic Church. It's the very, very first time we are live streaming a Sunday Mass from our beautiful St. John Neumann Gymnasium. And so I also welcome those who are joining us on the World Wide Web through our Facebook page and our YouTube, and so I ask you as well to please, just to make sure that they know that this is live, to turn around. Vince is the live streaming that. Turn around, everybody say hi, and say, wave to them, hello, welcome, thank you for joining us. As well, I'd like to offer today's Mass for Betsy Sarsfield, who celebrates her birthday. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit,
amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all. As we prepare to celebrate this Eucharistic mystery, let us hold in mind our sins. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters,
that I have prayed to you, my thoughts, and my words, and what I have done, and what I have failed to do, and
forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Let us pray. Gladden us with holy joys, Almighty God, and make us rejoice with devout thanksgiving for the ascension of Christ your Son in our exaltation. And where the head has gone before in glory, the body is called to follow him. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one now, forever and ever.
A reading from the beginning of the Acts of the Apostles. In the first book, Theophilus, I dealt with all that Jesus did and taught until the day he was taken away, after giving instructions through the Holy Spirit to the apostles whom he had chosen. He presented himself alive to them by many proofs after he had suffered, appearing to them during 40 days and speaking about the kingdom of God. While meeting with them, he enjoined them not to depart from Jerusalem, but to wait for the promise of the Father, about which you have heard me speak. For John baptized with water, but in a few days you will be baptized with the Holy Spirit. When they had gathered together, they asked him, Lord, are you at this time going to restore the kingdom to Israel? He answered them, it is not for you to know the times or seasons that the Father has established by his own authority. But you will receive power when the Holy Spirit comes upon you, and you will be my witness in Jerusalem, throughout Judea and Samaria, and to the ends of the earth. When he had said this, as they were looking on, he was lifted up, and a cloud took him from their sight. While they were looking intently at the sky as he was going, suddenly two men dressed in white garments stood beside them. They said, Men of Galilee, why are you standing there looking at the sky?
This Jesus, who has been taken up from you into heaven, will return in the same way as you have seen him going into heaven. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Ephesians. Brothers and sisters, may the God of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of glory, give you a spirit of wisdom and revelation, resulting in knowledge of him. May the eyes of your hearts be enlightened, that you may know what is the hope that belongs to his call, what are the riches of glory in his inheritance among the holy ones, and what is the surpassing greatness of his power for us who believe, in accordance with the exercise of his great might, which he worked in Christ, raising him from the dead and seating him at his right hand in the heavens, far above every principality, authority, power, and dominion, and every name that is named, not only in this age, but also in the one to come. And he put all things beneath his feet and gave him his head over all things to the church, which is his body, the fullness of the one who fills all things in every way. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Disciples went to Galilee, to the mountain to which Jesus had ordered them.
When they saw him, they worshipped, but they doubted. Then Jesus approached and said to them, "All power in heaven and on earth has been given to me. Go, therefore, and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, teaching them to observe all that I have commanded you. And behold, I am with you always, till the end of the age." The Gospel. Well, good morning, and once again, welcome back. How great it is to see everyone here. May, the month of May, Mary, Memorial Day, Mothers, Graduation, COVID-19, Pentecost, and an inspirational story. I tried to put that all into one, but we have to be out of here by 2 o'clock, that's sketchy. Today, we celebrate the Feast of the Ascension, or as some of us older people know it as Ascension Thursday. And there's a reason why we heard in our readings today Ascension Thursday, because we very much have a numerology. We know there's a number of disciples, a number of sacraments, a number of days in the week which we should work. And so the number 40, the Jews having spent 40 years in the desert, that Lent being 40 days long. The Feast of the Ascension to be 40 days after the resurrection, and then 10 plus more days for 50 days, which we'll celebrate next week, the Pentecost. So today we celebrate Ascension Thursday on Sunday. Doesn't really matter what day we celebrate the Ascension. It's more about the purpose and the idea, the theme of what the Ascension is all about. How on an Ascension, the Lord shows us the way. The Lord goes up, gives us hope, gives us a sense of direction that, yes, we, in our mortality, want to know where we can go, how we can ascend and elevate our lives. Well, this is being the month of May. It's the first time and the last time I'll get to see you live in this month of May. And so we began the month of May with praying and paying honor to Mary. Mary is the month of May, is for Mary, and May that is so full of Mother's Day. But who could understand this concept of the Ascension more than Mary? Mary, who was with Jesus that whole time, his 33 years of public ministry, who was there through having losing her son. Even after the resurrection, for these 40 days, finally, Jesus goes up, ascends up to heaven, the losing of a son. And yet, on August 15th, we will celebrate the Holy Day of Obligation, the Feast of the Assumption, when Mary as well will ascend into heaven, be made Queen of Heaven and Earth. Many people get those two mixed up. They sound very similar, especially if you have a mask in your mouth, Ascension and Assumption. But we celebrate today, where are we going? The possibilities that are available to us, and how that plays well into what we celebrate civilly in a secular world today. This weekend, as we celebrate Memorial Day, it's the secular version, it's the civil version of what we celebrate in the fall, that of All Souls Day. But yet today, as we celebrate Memorial Day, we remember and we honor those who gave everything they had for us. It says that there is no greater love than one who will lay down their lives for others. The parents, the mothers and fathers who have given up, who've lost their sons and daughters in battle and war. And they know that their ascension gives them peace, that they too can ascend to heaven. We give honor and gratitude and appreciation for those civilly who have ascended, for those who are given their lives. The mothers today, as we celebrate this month of May, we celebrated mothers. What mother cannot, especially as school is out, appreciate the losing of a child? As that child maybe has graduated in the last couple of weeks, graduation, they're hopefully going off to college or going off or moving out of the house, there's that sense of loss. But there's that sense of ascension. That ascension, that they're moving up. They're taking that next step. That Feast of the Ascension is one of hope and joy, uplifting. Those graduations that we've celebrated over the next couple weeks of progressing, that image that God gives us. Yes, there may be some loss, there may be some sadness in losing the physical presence of someone by us, but knowing that they're going up into heaven to be with Jesus, to be with Mary, gives us all of that peace, brings us to peace. And yet, how does that deal with, and how does that relate to, how is that relative to what we're going through as a country, as a world today with COVID-19? Do we not need to have that cloud of fear and death lifted from us as well? We ask you, Jesus, to lift this cloud from us. And maybe, just like the disciples in our reading today, we will ask, when? When is it going to happen? It's been 2 months already. Not for us to know that time. That cloud of fear, this harshness that has been over us, God, we ask you to ascend this from us. As we continue on next week, we will celebrate the Pentecost, those 50 days. 50 days after the resurrection. When Jesus, who ascends into heaven, will send down the Advocate, the Holy Spirit. We're called in this gospel to go out and be that great commission, to go out and baptize others, to bring that faith that, yes, that we have in our hearts, that faith of hope to others. For we come together and gather today, live and in person, by video stream, with that faith, being a people of faith, hope, and love, and optimistic people. But I would guarantee you that maybe you have friends or family members or neighbors who are not as hopeful, who maybe are experiencing some depression, who maybe don't have that faith, who have that doubt. And that's where that great commission that comes in our gospel, as Jesus sends them out, we're called to share that with others. That sense of hope, that sense of ascension in our lives. I guess we need to lift our souls and we need to lift our spirit as Jesus was ascended into heaven today. Right, well, I want to give you two quick stories. I mentioned an example and I began the Mass, but as well, I want to say the Mass today for Betsy Sarsfield, who I said celebrates her birthday. For those of you who a living example of one who's gone out and spread that gospel. For those of you who do not know Betsy, you may know her or of her for her actions from the Catholic Missal. Betsy is a member of St. Clair Catholic Church on Daniel Island. The pastor there is Father Gregory West, who's a classmate, who's ordained with Father Sandy. And so a person who has truly shared that faith, that sense of hope, going out and baptizing. About 7-8 years ago, a group of people, Sandy being, Betsy being one of the original group, the founding church, got together and went to Bishop Julio Moy and said, you know, there's all these Catholics moving into Daniel Island. Can we have a church? And so they said, well, start slow. You know, we have Bishop England High School. You know, why don't you start and you can meet in the gym and you can have Mass there once a month. So once a month, they started something called the Good Shepherd Club. The Good Shepherd Club. And first year only, Bishop William Loney came to me and said, Bob, you know, I said, Bob, would you mind saying Mass for once a month? Sure, whatever. And they built, and they built, and they grew, and they grew. And if you read the Catholic Missal, you know, after a few years, they were granted permission to become a parish, and now they're known as St. Clair's Catholic Church. How many people have they approached and affected? Have they shared and baptized in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit? Have they evangelized? Have they gone out on that great mission on Daniel Island? They're in the process now of Father West has been pastor only for 5 years there, and you may know that they were the ones who, in 1 month, they raised $14 million to build their church. So I give you as an example of one who goes out to that commission today. that good example of Betsy Sarsfield, the founders of the Good Shepherd Club on Daniel Island, to go out and spread that faith, baptizing in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Quick inspirational story, a quick uplifting story, a quick Ascension Thursday story. So, this past Thursday, during the week, you know, we have Mass here at 12 o'clock on Monday, Wednesday, Thursday, Tuesday is 9, and then Thursday as well, we have a 7 p.m. in Spanish. So, Thursday morning, about 10 minutes to 12, I got a call from a very good friend of mine, a pastor in New York. And as it turns out, that the governor of New York is going through the same thing we're going through. As a matter of fact, that's ground zero. That's the epicenter. They've been through it much, much, much worse. And so they were not allowed to have religious services. So on Wednesday night, the governor of New York made the announcement that beginning on Thursday, they could have religious services. But only 10 people could come to these religious services. So, as was normal, the deacon who was in his upper 80s would come in every morning to the parish and would unlock the church at 7 o'clock in the morning. They would keep the church open from 7 a.m. to 7 p.m. so that people could come in and pray. And the deacon came to the church at 7 a.m. to open, and it was cold, nasty, rainy, windy. And as he put the key in the front door to open up and open it, Thursday morning, the first day that they were able to have religious services, 40 parishioners in line, perfectly practicing social distancing, 6 feet apart, with masks on, no scheduled mass. But it was the Feast of the Ascension. So the deacon ran over to the church and knocked on the door to my friend, the pastor, and said, "Father, you won't believe it. There's 40 people waiting outside to get into church." He quickly threw on his clothes with no mass to be scheduled and ran over to the church. And sure enough, there were 40 people. "There's no mass scheduled, but I will offer mass for you until the last person is here." And so my friend, pastor, who's in his late 70s, said mass at 7:30, 8 o'clock, 8:30, 9 o'clock, 9:30, 10 o'clock, 10:30, 11 o'clock, and 11:30. 9 masses in a row. Or could they only could have 8 people, with the deacon and the priest was 10 people. And as people kept on coming and coming and coming, as word spread about the Mass, that, my friends, is the story of the Ascension. That story of hope, of people hungry for the sacraments, of people who are willing to stand in the cold, the wind, the rain, perfectly socially distancing and 6 feet apart, wearing masks. Yes, my friends, people who need to have their souls, their spirits ascending. A very, very inspirational story. Do we as well appreciate the presence of God at Ascension as well? May we take these coming days, just like the disciples, we don't know how long it will last, days or weeks or months or years. Will we take that great commissioning we heard in our gospel and share our faith with others in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Let's stand for our profession of faith. I believe.
Thank you.
Let us offer our prayers to the Lord.
For the church, that we continue to carry on the commission Christ gave to his first disciples, preaching, teaching, and baptizing throughout all nations, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That all nations lay down their arms and resolve never again to use instruments of death to resolve disagreements and discord, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those who suffer from systemic persecution, oppression, and discrimination, that justice and righteousness may overcome sin and evil, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those to be welcomed into the church next weekend on the solemnity of the Pentecost, as they go forth to make disciples in the way that they live their faith-filled lives, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of us, that we may be blessed with wisdom and hope, so that we may be effective witnesses in our communities of the joy and consolation of our faith, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the healing of all those who are suffering the effects of the coronavirus or who are ill in any way, and for their caretakers, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all our loved ones who have passed away, especially Frida Ryder, Marlo Citroen, Javier Alcorta, Clara Mungra, and for all those who died of COVID-19, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Now in silence, we offer prayers for those who we hold in our hearts, those who have asked for our prayers, and those who have no one to pray for them. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord God, you know all of our prayers, even those prayers we keep in the silence of our hearts. We ask that if they conform to your will, you allow them to be. And we ask this through Christ, our Lord. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the life we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human. Pray, brethren, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. We offer sacrifice now in supplication, O Lord, to honor the wondrous ascension of your Son. Grant, we pray, that through this most holy exchange, we too may rise up to heavenly realms. Through Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your heart.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For the Lord Jesus Christ, the King of glory, conqueror of sin and death, ascended today up to the highest heavens as the angels gaze in wonder. Mediator between God and man, judge of the world and Lord of hosts, he ascended not to distance himself from our lowly state, but that we, his members, might be confident of following where he, our head and founder, has gone before. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exults in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord. Jesus Christ, at the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, and giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all, and eat it, for this is will be given up for him." Similar way, when supper was ended, took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, take this home. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of a new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this. The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity together with Francis, our Pope, and Robert, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all. And with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and graciously grant peace in our days that, by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Peace in the Lord be with you all.
Amen.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper. Let us pray. Almighty, ever-living God, who allowed those on earth to celebrate divine mysteries, grant, we pray, that Christian hope may draw us onward to where our nature is united with you, through Christ our Lord. Just one quick announcement. People have been asking about they want to stay afterwards and have some devotional time to pray. So they want to remain in the church, but you know, we have to clean it and prepare it for the next mass. We cannot allow people to stay in the church, but we invite you to remain, those who want to remain in our gym church, that we have devotional places set up around campuses, and that our readers would be more than happy. So that's it. That's the first historic live streamed Sunday Mass in the beautiful St. John Neumann Gymnasium Church. Congratulations, you were part of this. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. The Mass is ended. Go in peace.
Thanks be to
God.
that